my respectful pranams to every one of you. When yesterday, the 60th birthday or birth anniversary of Mata Amritanandamayi was celebrated, millions and millions of people, her devotees, volunteers, and the students studying in Amrita institutes, they involved in that celebration. Many Christians and priests, many Muslims and priests and Hindus attended the 3-4 days program connected with the 60th birth anniversary of 60th birthday of Mata Amritanandamayi. Other than the religious leaders, many politicians, including chief ministers from different religion, attended the program, inaugurated the program, participated in the program, and congratulated for the service done to the society by Mata Amritanandamayi Math and the volunteers associated with the organization plus well-wishers. To me, Amma Mata Amritanandamayi is an integrating force of science, social service, and spirituality. Science, society, and spirituality. All the three starts with S. So, Amma did not have very high academic qualification. She had only less than fourth standard, lower primary level. But for managing such a huge series of institutes, whether it is hospital, social service center, colleges, schools, orphans, and mentally and physically handicapped human alayas, houses, building houses, providing support for the poor in India and outside. For doing all these things, one need not have to have a PhD or a higher academic certificate. With the devotion, dedication and sincerity, self-practiced and declared that is the ultimate aim, and when the world come to know that, this dedicated, devoted and sincere service provided to people, including in developed countries like America, when Katrina, Rita, Wilma, Alberto, Juno, Hurricane and Tornado hit America, thousands and thousands of Amma's devotees participated in the social service organized by the MUT in collaboration with the governmental service. Many people were given food, many people were given shelter, many people were given protection. Same thing another developed country in Japan. When Japan hit a few months ago with a tsunami, Amma could provide the helping hand to the people of that developed country. Same way, when tsunami hit Sri Lanka, Sri Lankan Prime Minister directly visited the mud and Amma and requested for the help that was given by way of building many houses in Sri Lanka. And I need not tell what happened in Gujarat and Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu and Kerala when earthquake and tsunami hit. So a spiritual leader need not be spiritual oriented all the 24 hours, 7 days, 365 days of any year. They can involve in the spiritual activity and the spiritual, applied spirituality can be used for the prayer Loka Samasta Sugino Bhavandu. And when we pray according to the Vedic message, Sarve Bhavandu Suginaha, Sarve Sandhu Niramaya, Sarve Badrani Pasyandu Ma Kaschit Dukkha Bhavet. The meaning, I am sure it is clear to you. Let everyone become happy. Let everyone live a healthy life. Let nobody suffer from the diseases and let nobody feel the negatives of this society. Ma kaschit dukkha bhag bhavet. Nobody face the situation of sorrow. That is the message given by ancient Indian rishis as told by Gujarat's Chief Minister Narendra Modi. And that is a message given by the Veda and how it can be applied in the society. That Amma's group is demonstrating to the world, like Sai Baba could build Sai Ganga for distributing drinking water to Chennai from Andhra Pradesh with the support of the volunteers and devotees. The spirituality that health, education and food that should be given to the people. As I told yesterday, Janaseva, Janardana Seva, Manava Seva, Madhava Seva. So that Seva is the applied spirituality. Sai Baba could build a huge Sai Ganga project to solve the problem of Tamil Nadu, even when the so-called portfolio bearing politicians and ministers and the ruling system could not do that. The government could not do that, but he could do that. And that he did without converting the Christians or Muslims to Hindu Dharma and telling them to be a good Christian, telling them to be a good Muslim. And then he gave water and other thing not only for the Hindus but also for the other community people. Same way, Amma has got still wider area of service. Hundreds and hundreds of schools, not only in India, all over the world. Colleges, professional institutions, and so on. The services are given at reduced rate, definitely may not be free for the non-deserving people, but for the deserving people it is free. For building such a huge institute, huge infrastructure, money should be taken from those who have got money, those who have rich money. With money from the rich, money should be taken and should be given to the poor people. As simple as that. But why the rich give the money to Amma and Sai Baba? Because they know that it will be properly utilized. And why they are not giving such money to the politicians? They know plenty well that it will be improperly utilized. and you can see the spirituality is converted into applied spirituality, and values are inculcated to the children, to the students studying in Amma's organization, and they are at the highest level of value enriched disciplined students, and ultra modern knowledge is imparted to the students, which you might have seen through the television channel and the newspapers. Many nanotechnology based products, including drugs developed by Amritanandamayi Math for the last 3-4 years, those nanotechnology based products could be released during the 60th birth anniversary of Mata Amritanandamayi. And remember that it is not a spiritual action, it is an ultra modern science. So ultra modern science, ultra modern technology, ultra modern social service, ultra modern educational facilities can be incorporated to the organization run by the spiritual leaders. As in India, you can see Vedas are written by the rishis, Ramayana is written by the great rishi, Mahabharata and Darshanas are written by great rishis, and the high quality scientific literature like Charaka Samhita, Sushruta Samhita, Ashtanga Hridaya, Ashtanga Sangraha, Yendra Sarvaswa, Amshu Bodhini, and so many other books, including Sex Vatsyayanas, Kama Shastra, and Chyavana Maharshi's Chyavana Prasada tonic, natural tonic, and Sarangadara's music, Sangeeta Ratnakara, Bharata Muni's Natya Shastra. Just to think like that. Which religion could provide such bundle of knowledge in variety of scientific and spiritual field by keeping themselves in the level of rishis, munis and maharshis, and extrapolate that up to now 2013, you can see Sri Narayana Guru also advocated to start industries, and Sri Narayana Guru advocated to start organization for educating the people by integrating Sanskrit and English, and he told the people to unite for seeing that they are socially developed. So right from Valmiki Maharshi, Vedavyasa, Vedic Rishis, Shankaracharya, Swami Vivekananda, Narayana Guru, and up to Amma, Sai Baba and Ravi Shankar Guruji, they are doing the spiritual activity and applied spiritual activity through spirituality and through science and technology. Here comes the real Sanatana Dharmic value. Without discriminating anyone, the social service opportunities are given to many people. When Amma visited America, I was also there. I happened to be there. And in Chicago, I was fortunate enough to visit the place where she was delivering a lecture discourse. Hundreds of nuns attended the program. Hundreds of Muslim priests attended the program. They came nearer to Amma and took even the blessing from Amma, which I was the witness for that. So what I wanted to convey, without discriminating the people of religion, without discriminating the politicians, you can see yesterday's program, respectable Chief Minister of Kerala, Umman Chandi, is an Orthodox Catholic Christian. And he attended the program and congratulated the Math for doing so much service. and Sikh leader was there, a Maulavi or Muslim leader was there, and we Sarva Mata Samabhavana, Sarva Jana Samabhavana, that could be demonstrated yesterday. And if you are going to Amrita Institute of Medical Science in Edappally, where I used to go and deliver lecture once in a while, I used to listen the messages that many politicians are coming there, particularly the politicians who used to criticize Amma, who used to stand in the opposite side as atheist or the so-called progressives. They reserve their room in Amrita Institute in spite of their having their own medical college and their own medical center. They come to Amma and Amma's center and get the treatment and very comfortably go outside, including Christian nuns and fathers I have seen in that hospital coming there. There is nothing great in what I am telling, I know pretty well. But what I wanted to convey, the service given by the Math, Mata Amritanandamayi Math, it has never got a boundary wall. It brings everyone outside to inside. Everyone outside to inside, make them happy, and giving the feeling that Amma is praying for them and giving free services and free medical treatment for the most deserving group of Christians, Muslims and Hindus. And the everyone, Akashat Patitam Doyam Yadagachati Sagaram Sarvadeva Namaskaram Keshavam Pratigachati. This is the message given by Mata Amritanandamayi Amma in UNO when she was delivering the lecture on international unity. So right from serving the poorest up to giving lecture in UNO and starting the professional colleges with ultra modern nanotechnology, having only fourth standard education on the other hand, these are all integration. This is what is meant by integration. Integrating the society, integrating the intellectuals and the poor, integrating the socially needy people with those who can provide the service, support the program. Like that one can see that an ideal Sanatana dharmic procedure of Indian culture adopted in Amma's activities. When tsunami hit, hundreds and thousands of houses were built and given to the fishermen in Karnagapalli, Alappuzha area, without even looking into the religion, the political background or any other criterion. Generally other people look into when that religious group provide this service for their group. They do it for either converting or getting the support. But here, nobody, no media, no politician, no agency and others have criticized. Nobody has criticized for the service rendered by Amma's group. The television channel on the one hand and educational series of institution on the other, and starting entirely novel courses, new subject, providing education to Indians and foreign students alike, and establishing ashrams world over, bringing even the rulers together, guiding them for satya dharma niti nyaya, and making them devotees of the dharmic values, encouraging them to do good things, and keeping them away from corruption and fraud. And all these things are being done without the overdose of spirituality. Without the overdose of spirituality. I was also once lucky to meet Amma in Kaimanam Ashramam near Trivandrum when I had to give an introductory lecture of Mata Amritananda Bai. At that time, she told me that you need not come to me at all. You spread the message of India. You spread the message of Dharma. I am with you. So that message of encouragement, motivation, that makes thousands and thousands of gentlemen and women to follow the pathway of serving others, doing the best to the society without expecting anything in return. As told in Bhagavad Gita, yajñārthāt karmaṇonyatra logoyam karma bandhanah tadattam karma gaundeya mukta saṅghas samācara. Do the society social service, do all type of activity with an yajña bhava, that you are doing a tyaga and yaga, yajña bhava, so that you will not have bondage with that. You will be going on serving the society without expecting anything in return for the personal honor or for the personal benefit. Maybe the society will be benefited out of that. But there is no selfishness. So Amma's emblem gives Tyage Naike Amritattva Manashu Na Rajyam Na Prajaya Na Dhanena. The wealth will not make you happy. Followers will not make you happy. The lordship of a country will not make you happy. Tyage naike amritattva manasuhu. Only by relinquishing, giving up whatever you have got and retaining just whatever is needed, that tyaga bhava, sacrifice, that only can make you happy. And in fact, hundreds and thousands of professors, I'm using the word hundreds and thousands with its literal meaning, not exaggerated meaning. Hundreds and thousands of professors, hundreds of doctors, hundreds of scientists, hundreds of youth taking diksha from Amma, many, many thousands of students, they participate in the social activity exclusively for that message of Tyage Naike Amritattva Manasuho. By spending your time, by spending your money, by spending your energy, you are enjoying by Yajna Bhava based karma, for which there is the need of an excellent leader, the most, very least educated, least educated Amma is leading the most educated people. I would like to repeat that line. Least educated Mata Amritanandamayi is leading the most educated doctors, scientists, scholars, thinkers, artists, professors, and so on. Everyone can be happy. Everyone can be converted from unhappiness to happiness if you give the ultimate focus of service. If you give the ultimate focus to wealth, position or something else, the moment you get a higher position, you will be further dejected if you are not getting still higher. If you get $1 million, your mind will crave for $2 million. If you became the Prime Minister of India, then your craving will be to get the same position in the next tenure also. If you became a state minister, your aim will be to become central minister. Central minister will have the aim to become cabinet minister. Cabinet minister will have the aim to become prime minister. You know, in India, many people, they think only about sitting at least a week on prime minister's chair. So their greed, their craving will not end by getting what they expect. It will further grow. Whereas tyagena ige amrutatva manasuhu, by relinquishing, by giving up, by just unowning, not owning what you are getting and giving it to the social service, as done in Naraseva, Narayana Seva, and in environmental protection, protection of earth, water, animals, protection of the unhappy people, mentally handicapped people, environmentally affected people. So that might have been giving them, that is giving them, that will be giving the devotees of Amma the utmost happiness. And you know, andam tama pravishandiye avidyam upasade tato bhuya ivade tamo yavu vidyayam dadaha. Those who are thinking that science can solve all the problem, they are leading themselves into blinding darkness. Tato bhuya ivade tamo yavu vidyayam dadaha. Those who are thinking that spirituality can give all the needed thing, all the solution for the present problem, they are also leading themselves into blinding darkness. So an integration of science and spirituality is the need of 21st century, as told by Swami Vivekananda, Aravinda Maharshi and Narayana Gurudev, including Mahatma Gandhi. Keep away from others, politicians and others. So we can see integration of science and spirituality could be shown as an example to the people of the world. What even UNO could not do, what even developed countries could not do, what the union of the countries could not do, to a great extent Amma could do. That is why her 50th birthday, Golden Jubilee, was celebrated by the people from 190 countries, bringing water from their holy river. And when the holy river waters got mixed with Ganga water kept in Kallur Stadium, Ernakulam, Kerala, and the mixing was done by Dr. E.P.J. Abdul Kalam, the most renowned, famous Indian scientist. And during then, 10 years ago, people from 192 countries assembled with waters, including from Saudi Arabia, Dubai, Abu Dhabi, and many hardcore Muslim and Christian countries. And remember, this time, the students from 192 countries assembled and offered flowers for this great celebration. Thus, my request, India, one of the greatest and the oldest country, is still spreading the great messages of Valmiki, Vedavyasa, and great renowned scientists and spiritual leaders. Continuously, Sanatana Dharma is flowing like Ganga water, and that Sanatana Dharma, like Ganga water, used to get polluted in certain areas where purification is needed. Sanatana Dharma also get polluted in certain areas, and the purification is done by people like Amma, avatars like Amma, Sai Baba, Sri Sri Devi Shankar, Swami Narayana, Dayananda Saraswati, Swami Vivekananda, Aravinda Ghosh, and so on. The rishis who attained the level of incarnation, the God in human form, we can say, the God in human form. So remember that. Our duty is to spread that light to others, the messages to others, make India the spiritual capital of the world, and Indian spirituality is spreading world over. Indian yoga, Vedic mathematics, Vedas, Puranas, Itihasas, Indian music, Indian dance, Indian food system, Indian family system, Indian society systems, and Indian Arthashastra, Indian educational systems are spreading world over. Like that, the messages of Amma and others should also spread world over, because it is Indian message. It is Sanatana Dharmic message applicable for anyone and everyone in the world. Anyone and everyone, I mean 720 or 715 crore people. Right from Obama up to Osama, these messages are applicable. And I request you, whether you like Amma, you like Sai Baba, you like Sri Sri Ravi Shankar or not, but the messages are universal. Accept those messages. What is told by them, and what is the relevance of what is told by them to the present century and the people world over. I am sure that even if you cannot become a bulb or a generator, we can become an electric post. We can become an electric post. The bulb is swinging on that top. The higher the position of the bulb, reasonably the area where the light will be available will be high. So you be an electric post, so that the light will be spreading to the people who are coming under that. That bulb need not go everywhere. But remember that bulb can give the light to the people who are coming under that street light. They will become happy. They enjoy the life. Their life will be useful, fruitful, purposeful, and meaningful. With these words, my pranams to you. Thank you very much.